The electronic guitar is also dismissed as nothing but a jangling noise machine, incapable of subtlety or delicacy. Lead guitarist Eric Clapton has built his reputation as a blues player on just these qualities, subtlety and delicacy. He explains, for example, how his guitar has four primary controls, controls for volume and controls for tone quality.
Those two are the volume. This one is for that pickup, and that one is for that pickup. And this is the tone for that pickup, and this is the tone for that pickup. And just by, you know, turning them all off or turning them all on, you can get a completely different sound. You know, you just get... And you get it very, very thin, like this. It's what you play when you've done that. Makes a difference, you know, because you can play...
What do you mean by that?
Well, you know, just the amount of pressure you put on with the flat pick, you know, because you can hit the strings very hard or hit them very soft, you know, or just touch them at any volume. You see? Now I can play that at the same volume, but softer.
The sound that's characteristic of electric guitars is the wah-wah effect that you make with the pedal.
I have to kick this to start it.
Could you play some and explain how it's done?
As I rock the pedal, you can hear it through the amplifier. As I rock the pedal, it takes bass off and puts treble on, you see, like that. So in actual fact, your volume isn't going down very much, but the tone is going wah wah like that.
Another characteristic of your particular playing is a kind of whining noise, usually described as woman tone.
Yeah, let me turn this thing off.
Can you tell us what that is?
The woman tone is produced by using either the bass pickup or the lead pickup, but with all the bass off. And in fact, if you use both pickups, you should take all the bass off on the tone control. That is to turn it down to one or oh, you know, on the tone control, and then turn the volume full up. You know, and it's supposed to sound like this. The kind of blues I play I started playing was one of accompaniment, you know, of lead accompaniment. So that is quite difficult, you know. There are basic things that you'd have to learn about that style itself, which is the finger vibrato that you have to use, which is like that, you know. Which is very important.
Could you just do that again?
Yeah. You see, that itself is very difficult, can take you a long, long time to play and get that perfected.
When you're improvising, do you use stock phrases as the raw material? And if so, can you share some?
Yeah, there are phrases that I always play that are stock phrases that I work from, you know, which are just like... All these runs, you know, are put together from old phrases that I first started on, like... They're just all kind of messed up with other things which I learned like that, you know, which is... If a guy likes playing football, then that's what he'll use to get all of his kind of basic kind of angry bits out of him, you know, that you build up through any day, you know. You can just, like, someone will toot the horn in the car behind you and you'll get angry and you'll have no release for it, you know. Well, that happens to everybody, but you know, like... I've got the advantage of being able to sort of play that out on the guitar by being sort of fairly aggressive in the way I play, not the way I use it. Well, that can be done too, you know, with people like The Who.
Can you show us?
And Pete Townsend. What do you mean? You want me to break the guitar up?
Well, no, not quite. Just an example of aggression in your music.
Yeah, right.